New 8th grade students must pay attention to this physics relative motion problem. You must know how to solve it. Here are two photos showing different times. This one was taken first, this one was taken later, giving us some reference objects to judge if these objects are stationary or moving in which direction. For this type of problem, we follow a process that gives us the answer directly, just draw some arrows. How do we draw them? Start from the reference object and draw an arrow toward the object you're judging. For example, option A uses the street light as reference, so I'll start from the street light to judge the truck's motion. I'll draw an arrow to the truck. This is the arrow at the first moment and the same for the second moment reference object to starting point pointing to the truck. Then compare the difference between the two arrows. How do we compare? Move their starting points to the same position. For example, I shift this arrow over, it should look something like this. This is the first moment, this is the second moment. The arrow's end moved from here to here. We just mentioned the arrow's end represents the object you're judging, so this object relative to the streetlight is moving to the left, so option A is correct. Why do we align the starting points? Remember what the starting point is? It's the reference object. Isn't that the object assumed to be stationary? Aligning the starting points corresponds to assuming the reference is stationary, then we judge the endpoint, which is the object you're studying, to see which direction it's moving. Using the same method, let's look at options B, C, and DB uses the tree as reference. So I'll use a tree as the starting point to judge the streetlight's motion, drawing from the tree to the streetlight. The second moment also points from tree to streetlight. You'll find these two arrows are identical after you shift them together. They completely overlap. Overlapping means the endpoint hasn't changed. Position option B is correct, meaning the streetlight is stationary. Option B is correct. C uses the bicycle as a reference, so we'll start from the bicycle drawing arrows to the streetlight. The first moment arrow looks like this, the second moment becomes like this. Then align the starting points of both arrows, shifting it over. It looks something like this. This is the first moment, this arrow is the second moment the endpoint moved from here to here. Meaning the streetlight relative to the bicycle moved from right to left. It's moving leftward. That's correct. So option C is also correct. Finally, let's look at option D using the car as reference to judge the truck's direction of motion drawing from the car to the truck, shifting these two arrows together. If I move it over, it's roughly in this direction. This is the first moment. This is the second moment the truck moved from here to here. Relative to the car, it's moving from left to right. It's moving rightward. So option D is incorrect. Choose D if it's not correct. Did you understand?